In this video, we'll show you how to connect a domain name registered with Namecheap to a Squarespace website. This tutorial is relevant for you if your domain is using Namecheap Basic, Premium, or FreeDNS. If it is pointed to third-party name servers, you need to configure the DNS records on the side of your name server's provider. To get started, you need to assign the domain to your Squarespace website and find the correct DNS records to point your domain at. To do this, log into your Squarespace account. Click on the three dots next to the website in question and select Settings from the drop-down menu. Choose Domains from the menu on the left. Click on Use a Domain I Own button and enter the domain you want to assign. Then choose the Connect Domain option. Choose Namecheap from the Select Provider drop-down menu if it's not set automatically, and click on the Connect Domain button. This will reveal the DNS settings you need to connect your domain. Next, open a new tab in your browser and log into your Namecheap account. Move to the domain list and click on the Manage button next to the domain you'd like to use. Select the Advanced DNS tab. Here, you'll need to set up 4A and 2C name records and input the values as they appear on Squarespace. To do this, click on the Add New Record button and add each record one by one, selecting the respective record type from the drop-down menu. You may copy and paste the values from your Squarespace account. Once you're done, click on the Save All Changes button at the bottom. Also, double-check the settings for any conflicting records. If you have some other A, URL redirect, CNAME, or alias records configured for @ and www hostname, please remove them to avoid errors in the website's performance. Finally, go back to your Squarespace account and click on the Refresh Records button on the top right corner. If everything is configured correctly, you will see Record Found appear next to each one. Please keep in mind that the DNS settings may take up to 30 minutes to propagate globally. So if you see some errors, hit refresh again a bit later. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, you can post them under this video, or check out our knowledge base at namecheap.com for more tips and support.